Now we are going to do Bhadrasana. Bhadrasana is just nothing but butterfly, tittily. What you say and what you see in, you know, general life, it is an easy movement and everyone can do while you are sitting and watching TV and, you know, when you wanted to relax yourself entirely, then this asana is the best. So now, sitting in base position and stretching your knees and adding your both the feet together and clasp them with your fingers and hold them with your hands like this, lock them, interlock them. And now, both the legs are stretched and try to see the knees are placing on the ground. And at the same time, try to make a flat movement up and down with the knees, doing like this, tapping them on the ground as much as you can and try to make a sound out of it so that, you know, you will have the releasing the tension from your point, the inner muscles and inner thighs, the pressure point are tensions are released when you clap your knees like this on the floor, tapping them up and down, up and down. Try to see you're going to do this movement at least minimum 50 times. You repeat this, okay? The more you do, the more flexibility you get. I challenge you, can do it. Everyone can do it. Don't say that my knees are not going down and I cannot do it. No, everyone can practice. By regular practice, everyone can tap their legs like this. While doing this, you have to raise your knees like this, holding tight your toes, joining them together like this and tap them and raise them up. Tap them, raise them up. This is the first stage of doing Bhadrasana. The second stage you have is take your hands out, press the knees down and clap them up. Don't give any extra pressure, just let them spring them up. Tap them down, spring them up. Tap them down, spring them up. Tap them down, spring them up. This way. Okay? See how easy it is? It's not by the practice. Everyone can do it. The only thing is inner determination has to be there. So this is how you practice the Bhadrasana. After doing this, just relax yourself and take a deep inhalation. There is no breath control in this. You can just take deep breathings and breathe out while doing this. And now, after doing this, relax yourself and take a deep breath in and try to touch your head to the toes. Inhale, while exhaling, go down. See that? Your knees are touching the ground. Your head is touching the toes. Inhale, rise up. Repeat these movements for 3-4 times. You will have the flexibility and the pressure bump in and put your head touching to the toes. You can do it. That's what I suggest. And now, the benefits of this asana are, while doing this, everyone will be so tensed and in a day long time, the pressure of standing for a long time, you know, will be getting released. The inner thighs basically holds a lot of pressure in our human body. So, that all will be getting relieved and it gives you a good relaxation after a long standing and walking, a practice what you do in a day. You will be really relieved with doing this asana. I suggest you do and make it a practice every day and you will be relaxed and fresh and regenerated by doing this exercise by releasing all your tensions. The people who are not supposed to do this asana are sciatica people and sacral problem people are not supposed to practice this asana. I sincerely suggest you do this asana under the guidance. Thank you.